Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to another show, Soccer As We Like It. Euros has literally, it is flaming, it's burning, is football coming home? Right, there are final group matches between Group C and Group D. We're going to jump right into Group C. We'll go to Group D first, where Netherlands, Austria, Italy, sorry, Netherlands, Austria, France, and Poland were playing. Netherlands needed to win. Austria already had 3 points. Austria already had 4 points. So what Austria needed to do is just win and consolidate. Austria beat Netherlands by 3-2. The funny thing was, Austria started off with a goal, own goal from Mellen. That was an own goal that gave Austria the consistent pressure from Austria, managed by ex-Man United manager Ralf Rangnick. He's always said, play the football on the ground. And they were absolutely fantastic football they played. They tormented Netherlands. I actually felt sorry for Netherlands at this point. So Netherlands, because of the pressure from Austria, they conceded an own goal as early as the 6th minute. So at that point, Gakpo, who has been very, he's been, Gakpo has been really good for Holland, for the Netherlands. Let's call it as he has been phenomenal. He got an equalizer just as soon as the second half started. But as we know, Austria do not relent. Then Schmidt scored another goal, making it 2-1. 2-1 to Austria. But, substitutions were made. Weghorst was brought on. At that point, the game turned. Weghorst headed the ball down, and the power was there to smash it in. But Austria were not finished. They were not finished. Sabitzer, he has been the star. He scored a goal. He even scored another goal, which was disallowed. So the game ended. Netherlands 2, Austria 3. Austria actually won the group. They won the group, a group that had France and Netherlands. Austria came first. Wow. Austria and Poland and France played the 1-1. Lewandowski scored a penalty and Mbappe scored a penalty. So Netherlands, Austria first, France second. Netherlands will qualify as one of the good third place positions in Group C. Right, let's go to Group C. Now, Group C. Now, this was something. First, I'm going to ask you, is football coming home? Are England good enough to win the Euros? Playing like that? No. Absolutely, categorically, fundamentally, crystal clear, no. You can't play football like that. Lack of possession, lack of creativity, lack of finishing. I mean, they could not string enough passes. They can't keep the ball properly. I mean, was there an improvement against Denmark? Yes, because they didn't play Trent in the middle of the midfield. That was a difference. Palmer played well. I think he played well. I thought he wasn't bad. But the fact of the matter is this. Bellingham, since that first game against Serbia, Bellingham has been completely disappeared. Maybe he's tired. He looks lethargic. He's tired. But even Foden was better, a bit better today. I'll give you the stats for England and Slovenia. I mean, Slovenia needed a draw. They're so happy to be in the next stage. They are celebrating. They're having a party. But England were expected to be better. But they were just poor, absolutely piss poor. I don't know what is wrong with them. I don't know if they're stage fright. And people said, oh, England are better in knockouts. It's not about the knockouts, it's about what you perform on the day. And this has been very poor. You know what I mean? It's just not good enough. Harry Kane, he's going too deep to get the ball. And that's not where they want you, mate. I'm going to give the stats quickly. These are the stats. England had 73% possession and not a goal. What does that say? They cannot score. Slovenia only had 26 possession. England had 12 shots. Slovenia had 4 shots. England had only 4 shots on target. Slovenia had 1 on target. England had 6 corner kicks. Slovenia didn't have a single corner kick. But they could not score. If you can't score, you don't win a game. When it comes to knockout now, it's not even going to be about points anymore. It's you don't win, you're going home. It's that simple. Will England beat? We don't know. The draws are going to come out. We'll see. Because it's going to be first playing seconds and first playing thirds in groups. So the first two qualify automatically, then the best four third teams in the group across the groups, the best four teams that came third will now join which will make it to round of 16. Round of 16 will turn to round of 8. Round of 8 will turn to round of 4. Round of 4 will turn to round of 2. And the winner takes it all. Goodbye and good night. But this England squad currently, it's not happening, mate. It's definitely not happening. It's not. This was not good enough. It just wasn't good enough. Yes, England have qualified. Denmark and Serbia played another 0-0. So England came first, Denmark second, Slovenia third. Slovenia was celebrating, but England fans were booing England. Should they boo England? Not exactly boo them, but they're just trying to show frustration that they expect better. They expect a better high level of performances, especially when they have players who are supposed to be the technical player, the Foden's, the Bellingham, the Harry Kane's, the Rice. Rice was, he's all right, but there's nothing special about some of these players. They're playing good teams with good systems. But when they're put together, they seem to get lost in this Southgate system. But either ways, England nil, Slovenia nil, Denmark nil, Serbia nil, France 1, Poland 1, Netherlands 2, Austria 3. So Group C and Group D are completed. Austria came first in that group, France came second, and Netherlands come third. Poland out, going home. In England's group, England first, Denmark second, Slovenia third, Serbia going home. So this is what this situation is. So don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Do you think England could still win this? Is football coming home? If you think it's coming home, drop your comments. I'll see you on the next one. A day that England failed to score or have qualified for the next stage. I'll see you guys on the next one. From me, it's goodbye and good night.